Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch and the laws of Ribbis. We have two mahalachas, two more laws over here at the end of this chapter. Shutfin, shetzvichin livo ismaus beribbis me'akum. If you have two Jews that are partners and they need to borrow money on interest from a non-Jew, yasu shelas chacham eich lases. They should ask a rabbinic authority exactly how to proceed in this particular case. What is the shaila? The question over here is the following, that if you have two people that are taking out a joint loan together, that means that each one is actually borrowing only half of the money. And if the lender would demand payment in full from either one of them, then each one is a guarantor for the other. And if each one is a guarantor for the other, that means that the guarantor ends up having to pay ribbis on behalf of the other person, which we said previously is something that you're not allowed to do. So therefore, in this case, it's a shaila, it's a question. And if you get into such a situation, go and ask your local Orthodox rabbi. And the last halacha is a mumer, asa levas menu beribbis. A mumer, who is known in English as an apostate, which means that someone who has totally forsaken the Jewish religion, and therefore they're not really included so much within the realm of Klal Yisrael anymore. Nevertheless, since that they are still a Jew, by birth they are a Jew, therefore you're not allowed to borrow money from them, beribbis, with interest. Even to loan them money with interest, even though you have a person over here who denies the Torah and he doesn't believe in it anymore, but he is a Jew, and therefore you should be machme, you should be conduct yourself stringently and not lend them money with interest. Now this would be a very pertinent halacha. Let's say that you are a religious Jew and you are doing business with a non-religious Jew. So to a great extent, the man has a status of an apostate. He doesn't keep anything. He doesn't believe in anything. He doesn't conduct his life according to the laws of the Torah and the Halacha. And therefore, maybe you would think that you could loan him money with ribbis because he's not included in the categories of a Jew that is concerned about these things. No, the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch says it doesn't matter, even though he's still a Jew. And because he's a Jew, he's part of Klal Yisrael, therefore you must not lend or borrow money from such a person with ribbis. Okay, those are the halachas. I skipped around a little bit in this chapter because, as I said before, there's a lot of complicated cases. It would behoove anyone that wants to clarify things more for themselves to look into chapter or Simon 65 in the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, which goes through the laws of interest. There's a lot of footnotes over here which will explain things in more detail. Starting tomorrow, Be'ez Hashem, we're going to get to the chapter, what's called Iska, which is going to be the way in which the Torah allows a person to make a loan with ribbis, with interest, even when it's going to another Jew. There's a way to do it with documentation and sale of business and so on and so forth, like we'll see the details, called Heter Iska, which is the permissibility of the Iska, as we'll see what that means, and we'll start that, Be'ez Hashem, tomorrow. Wishing everybody a wonderful day.